So welcome students to our new chapter of quadrilaterals. Now before we begin with the chapter, let us first understand what are we going to learn in this chapter. First, we'll understand what is a quadrilateral. Then there are different types of quadrilateral like rectangle, square, rhombus. So we'll in the second section we'll understand the different types of the quadrilaterals, and then we'll understand the properties of each and every quadrilateral, and then based on those properties we'll solve the questions. Now let us do the first part, that what is a quadrilateral. Here is the definition of a quadrilateral, that it is a polygon having four sides, right? A polygon having four sides is known as quadrilateral. But what is a polygon? Now this is the definition of the polygon: a simple closed curve made up of line segments. Now these colored words are the keywords that you need to understand. What do we mean by simple, what do we mean by closed curve, and what do we mean by line segments. So these are the very important keywords to understand the definition of polygon. Now what is a simple? Simple means any curve that does not cross itself. So curve that does not cross itself, right? So that curve is known as a simple curve. Now what is a closed curve? A closed curve, I will simply write that closed curve is a curve which is not open. Now I'll give you some examples of these simple and closed curve. First let us understand this definition, that curve that does not cross itself. Now for example, this is a curve and this is also a curve, and then this is also a curve, right? These two curves are crossing itself at this point and at this point. So these two curves are not simple. So I have marked crossed. But this curve, right, the third one, is not crossing itself, right? So it is a simple curve. So I'll write over here simple. So you understand what is the difference between a simple curve and not a simple curve. So to be a polygon, the curve has to be simple. That means it should not cross itself. Now let us understand the closed curve. That means a curve which is not open. Now see, in these four examples, this is a curve, this is a curve, this is a curve. Now this curve is open, right? Because there is no demarcation between the internal area and the external area of the curve, right? So it is open from here, right? So this is not a closed curve. Now this is closed from all the four sides: this side, this side, this side, and this side, right? There is a proper demarcation between the external area of this figure and the internal area. This is the internal area, and all the area other than the internal area is the external area, right? So this is a closed curve. So I have written over here C. Now here it is a figure which is resembling to U, the letter U. Now this is also an open curve. This is open from this side. So it is again not a closed area, therefore, because there is no demarcation between external and internal area. But this is a figure resembling to the circle, and this is a closed curve because it is closed from all the four sides, and this area that lies outside this boundary is a external area, and the area lying within this boundary is the internal area, right? So this boundary is the demarcation between the internal and the external area. So it is a closed curve. Now let us understand the meaning of made up of line segments. What is the meaning of made up of line segments? You know what are line segments, right? So made up of line segments means, for example, this is a circle and this is a square, right? And we have a hut-like figure, this, right? And this is a random figure. Now, out of these four curves, this circle is not made up of line segments, right? You can easily see the boundary is not made up of line segment, but this square, it is made up of line segments. This is a line segment, this is a line segment, this is a line segment, this is a line segment. All the parts of the boundaries are made up of line segments. Similarly, this is also made up of line segment. This is a line segment, this is a line segment, this is a line segment, this and this is a line segment. Similarly, this random figure is not made up of line segments, it is made up of arcs. So again, this is not made up of line segments. Now, I have explained you the definition of the polygon. It should be simple, it should be a closed curve, and it should be made up of line segments, right? For example, this is a polygon. Why? Because it is simple, because it is not crossing itself, it is made up of line segments, and it is a closed curve. So it is a polygon, right? Similarly, this is also a polygon because it is made up of line segments, it is not crossing itself, and it is a closed curve. So yes, this satisfies the definition of polygon, and this is a polygon. But out of these two cases, this has four sides and this has six sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this has four sides. 1, 2, 3, and this is the fourth one. So a polygon which has four sides is known as quadrilateral. So these both are polygons, but only this is a quadrilateral because it is a polygon having four sides. But this is not a quadrilateral because yes, it is a polygon, but it does not have four sides. So this is the definition of the quadrilateral, that any polygon having four sides is known as quadrilateral.